With the permission of Honorable Minister for Science and Technology, Dr. Harshvardhan Ji, Secretary Science and Technology, Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Director General PIB, Shri Kuldeep Singh Datwalia Ji, and media friends. To put it in a single sentence, I would rather sum up saying that this is a day which marks the end of one chapter and the opening up of a new chapter. And it is, in fact, you would recall that over the last nearly 7 years, one after the other, under Prime Minister Narendra Modi, we have been able to liberate ourselves from a number of regulations, number of restrictions, which were, in fact, a legacy of the feudal mindset and also to an extent a legacy of the British Raj of the pre-independence era. And while on the one hand, we have got rid of as many as over 1,500 avoidable rules which had been done away with the intervention of Prime Minister Modi, this was an area, the sector of space, which was rather considered a taboo over the last 70 years since independence. And it worked, functioned behind a shroud of maybe secrecy or maybe mystery, very little known to the outside world. And you would recall that even in your younger days, if at all space made a news, it made a news only when there was a launching of a rocket happening from a place called Sriharikota, which was also forbidden for the common citizens, and we would just find one column news in the newspapers. Very recently, in a very revolutionary breakthrough, Prime Minister Modi, with his intervention and guidance, we could take the decision to, what I would say, unlock the space sector and to open it to a great extent to private participation in a number of ways which were actually permissible and safe to begin with. And this was a decision which was quite unimaginable till very recent past. And I think as a follow-up of that, now we have moved one step further and made a history today by announcing that map making in India stands completely deregulated from today. That is the 15th of February 2020. And this is in keeping with the agenda which has been followed by this government under Prime Minister Modi, the agenda of self-reliance, the agenda of Atmanirbhar Bharat. And therefore, keeping that as the focus, space technology and mapping would no longer be confined only as a tool to take care of the security areas, but also as a major tool for the development. And you would recall just about 4 years back, we had a brainstorming session lasting nearly 2 days. Again, it was with the personal intervention of Prime Minister Modi. There was an interaction between the space scientists on the one hand and representatives of the different ministries and departments on the other hand to work out how best space technology could actually contribute in different infrastructural areas. As a result of this, in the last 3 years, we have space technology being used in laying down of rail tracks, even the mapping of unmanned rail crossings. We have space technology in the smart city program, in the housing sector, in the construction of bridges. We have space technology in a big way in the agriculture sector for the welfare of the farmers, whether this is soil health card, whether it's DBT. We have telemedicine, tele-education, of course, further extended. And therefore, we have now actually entered a phase or an era where space technology has virtually entered every Indian household in one way or the other. And similarly, by making mapping accessible to other stakeholders, we would rather be incentivizing them to become partners in the development journey of New India led by Prime Minister Modi. And therefore, I would also invite the various stakeholders, the business houses also, to come forward to make best use of this new liberalization happening, which would in fact also take us closer to our 5 trillion economy goals. And With this liberalization, this would also encourage the PPP models in a bigger way. Our estimates indicate that by 2029, the geospatial economy would amount to as much as 99,000 crore, which would be able to generate employment for as many as 22 lakh people. And therefore, it's all the more reason that we enrich that potential and we contribute to that actually happening. And therefore, most importantly, this deregulation with freedom from avoidable restrictions will lead to a situation where there will be, as was being mentioned by Secretary S&T, there will be no need to regulate such information which is already available globally, because there was little sense in doing so, and we have actually done away from those shackles. And to conclude, I would just say that in a nutshell, this would also A, give you liberalization of mapping, B, no requirement for prior approval or other restrictions on the collection, generation, preparation, dissemination, publication, storage, updating, and digitalization of geospatial data and maps within the territory of India. And C, most importantly, self-certification to convey adherence to guidelines. You would recall that 2014, soon after this government came in, within 3 months, DOPT had taken a very historic decision of doing away with the British colonial practice of getting your certificates and documents attested through gazetted officers or through other authorized, to convey a message that, look here, this is a government headed by and of mapping in contributing to. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I invite Dr. Harshvardhan ji to brief the media, sir.